now to start the test, we're using the run test button on the upper part of the screen. The first time we run the test, we have the possibility to enter a test ID. That is for the whole batch of specimen that we are testing. Here I just entered a generic name, ASTM D6641, for the ASTM standard for the compression test, using the combined loading fixture. Then we can enter for each individual specimen. We can enter the specimen ID, generics like temperature, humidity, but also the specimen width, as a standard width, 1/2 inch, 12.7 millimeters. The thickness of the specimen is 4 millimeter, and the overall length is 140 millimeter. The template supports two types, untapped and tapped specimen, but we are using in our test an untapped specimen, so information with regards to distance between taps, length of end taps, and thickness of taps is not relevant. We're also supporting different types of strain measurement methods, dual strain measuring on both sides of the specimen or only on one side. In our case, we're measuring on both sides of the specimen so that we can evaluate the bending strain throughout the test. The initial test speed is set by default to the value recommended by the ASTM D6641 standard, 1.3 millimeter per minute. Now the specimen gets loaded, and initially at small strains we don't see the large values, but now as we can see, the load is increasing, the strain front and back, as well as the compressive average strain and the bending strain is calculated. The bending strain should stay throughout the test below 10% to be a valid test. We can see that our strain gauges failed, but we can complete the test till specimen failure. After the test is completed, we can enter the failure mode that occurred. We can also enter information with regards to where the failure occurred, the failure location, and any specific specimen comment in order to keep track of what actually happened during the testing at the specimen time the specimen fails. After the test is completed, we can automatically return to zero to be ready for the next test.